I've tried a lot of chicken recipes. Fried chicken's one of my favorite things to eat. And I stumbled across this Momofuku recipe, which is a restaurant that's in New York and a few other locations across the country. And this chicken recipe is really amazing. A lot of chicken recipes, when you do a fried chicken recipe, they'll use flour or some other type of coating on the outside. But this chicken is comfortable in its own skin. So we're starting out today with some chicken thighs and some chicken drumsticks. I normally like dark meat when I fry chicken. It's another extra safety feature to make sure that it stays juicy. If you cook with white meat, sometimes that can get a little dry. With this particular recipe, it's actually really hard to screw up, but I also tend to like dark meat better. The first step is we're gonna do a quick brine. Once the brine is done, we're gonna cook the chicken, and there's two different ways. I'm gonna show you in the sous vide today, but you can also steam it. Then it's gotta rest for a little while to dry out a bit, and then we'll fry it off. So we're gonna get started with the brine. The brine's real simple. It's just a half a cup of kosher salt, which I'm gonna put directly in here, half a cup of sugar, which this is just straight up white sugar, granulated sugar. Now, it calls for lukewarm water. And I normally subtract a little bit of the water out. There's about 3 cups of water in here and about a cup of ice. I normally like to, if I'm gonna put some meat into a brine, I like the brine to be at least a little chilled. So that's why I normally separate them out. So about 3 cups of water in here. I'm gonna stir it up. Like I said, it's just sugar and salt in here. And the sugar is actually really necessary because the sugar in this recipe gives this chicken an amazing coating that is like super golden brown at the end. And so the sugar is really necessary here. So once it's mixed and you see that it's pretty much dissolved, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start putting my chicken in here. And this has gotta sit for, it can sit for up to 6 hours, but at least an hour. So at least an hour worth of time. I'm gonna put this all in here. I'm gonna throw some ice on top of it to try to chill it as best I can. It's not gonna get super cold in here, but what I don't want is for it to get up, it to sort of sit in lukewarm water for a long period of time. I'm also gonna put this in the refrigerator. So I'm gonna cap it up here, wash my hands off, and we're just gonna stick it in the fridge for, at this point, I'm thinking it's probably gonna go in there for about an hour and a half to 2 hours. Like I say, it can go up to 6 hours. What I have here is an hour. The chicken has been sitting in here for an hour. It is in the brine that I made earlier. I'm just gonna take it and strain it really quickly. So the chicken just came out of the brine. I didn't wash it off or anything like that. It's really not necessary. You don't have to rinse it. I'm gonna put it in a sous vide bag, and then I'm gonna sous vide it at 165 degrees Fahrenheit for about an hour and a half. I wanna try to cook it all the way through, and I wanna make sure that it's cooked all the way down to the bone. So I'm gonna go for about an hour and a half at 165. It won't overcook in this bag, so we don't have to worry about that. If you're gonna be steaming this, now I don't have a bamboo steamer, but you need a steamer with many different levels on it, many different racks, and a bamboo steamer is perfect for that. You could also use other steamers if you have one, and you would just steam it for about 40 minutes. You would get the water up to a boil, put it in the steamer basket, and let it steam for about 40 minutes, and that would be about a similar cooking process to what I have here. Chicken, we're making what they call the Octo vinaigrette. Now, this is also from the Momofuku restaurant. This is a really amazing Asian dressing that you can dip the chicken in when it's completed, and it really enhances the whole dish. So what I have here are the ingredients, and I'm just gonna talk through them real quick. It's really just combine it, mix it, and then let it sit for a little while, and the dressing is done. So we're gonna start out with the liquid. I have here, I doubled the recipe, but you could certainly have this recipe. And if you have this recipe, it'll be a nice size. I love this stuff, so I always double the recipe when I get a chance. This is a half a cup of unseasoned rice wine vinegar and a half a cup of soy sauce. You wanna use low sodium soy sauce here. It's 4 tablespoons of a neutral oil. You can use grape seed, or I'm using peanut oil here. And this is not, you don't have to, it doesn't require an emulsion. You just need to stir it every time you serve it. You can't actually make an emulsion out of this. I have 4 tablespoons of minced garlic and 4 tablespoons of minced ginger. I have 2 serrano chilies that I seeded and diced fine. This is 3 tablespoons of white sugar. And I'm gonna whisk that up. And to the final bit, I'm gonna add 1/2 teaspoon of roasted sesame oil. This stuff goes a long way, so you don't wanna use a ton of it. So that's it. Now, every time you serve it, you just wanna give it a nice stir, but that's the vinaigrette, and we're gonna use this in the final dish. Chicken's cooked for about 1.5 hours. I have a rack here, and the plan is I'm gonna take this chicken, put it in this bowl, and then I'm gonna set it on this rack. And then it is gonna sit in my fridge between 2 to 4 hours to dry out. What we don't wanna do is we don't wanna take the chicken directly out of here and put it into hot oil, because it's gonna pop and spit and it's gonna shoot oil everywhere. So what we wanna do is try to dry the chicken out, the outside specifically of the chicken out, as much as possible. And so we're gonna put it on this rack and let it sit inside the fridge. Chicken's been resting for a while. We're gonna now put it into some peanut oil that I have at 350 degrees. We wanna try to get this so that the outside is nice and crisp, the inside is warm. And so you're gonna look for a nice deep golden brown color. The outside, nice and crispy, and the inside is nice and tender and juicy. And as you can see, I'm gonna tear it, and you can just see how much juice is inside of here. Dip it in the vinaigrette. It's perfect. It's really a foolproof way to make great fried chicken. And you don't miss any of the flour coating on the outside of the chicken that you normally get with a lot of other fried chicken. It's just the skin, and it's delicious. Well, I hope you enjoy this video, and let me know if you try this chicken. Post a picture of it in the comments.